What is a totally wrong thing that has become so widespread it's not considered wrong anymore? How much material classified as recyclable is, in truth, not recyclable? It's more a marketing win that kept people using plastics. Why else would China stop taking the world's trash? They could do nothing with it but bury it in the ground. Tying your health insurance to your work, USA. If you become too sick to work, example, terminal cancer, you lose your job and your healthcare coverage. Dental not being included in healthcare. How is the health of your mouth and teeth separate from the health of the rest of your body and necessitate totally different and pricey insurance? Harvesting as much data as possible. You have to go to some extreme lengths to prevent your personal information being sent to random strangers you have never met. For anyone with the aptitude, pie hole. You essentially set up a tiny PC and route all internet requests through it. Then give it a block list. Nothing connected to your network can complete requests to domains on the block list. Phone, PC, smart TV, washer, fridge, etc. Nothing. I honestly can't remember the last time I saw an ad, and it can block anything trying to phone home in the background as well. Bought a Samsung TV and setting it up required making a Samsung account. They know, by the time you unbox it and place it, that you have really no recourse but to relent and provide your account info. F-king extortion. I created an account in my dog's name for every item I purchase that requires me to provide an email to activate. My dog receives invitations to retirement seminars and assorted other advertisements. Give your pets some fun hobbies and create some crazy data for their customer analytics projects. This is my last Samsung phone because of the things they keep trying to force on me with every update. Making terms and conditions overcomplicated and long. Interestingly, because they are so long and dense, there have been several court cases in the US stating that they are not legally binding. Since you are not expected to actually read it, yeah, you can't have any gotcha clauses hidden deep within the boilerplate. Companies have to show that any unusual terms and conditions were communicated in such a way that the consumer knew exactly what they were getting into. I'd respect a company if their terms and conditions were in 18pt font. By clicking I agree, you are agreeing to not sue this company for any reason, ever. Also, just so you know, we will collect your data and sell it to third parties. I work for a company that has this and unfortunately it constantly backfires. People take the plain language as threatening when what it's really doing is being upfront about the terms and conditions without hiding behind fine print. Websites selling personal information by default. Taking pictures of strangers who aren't doing anything wrong or untoward just to post up on social media with some snark or judgment. In middle school I was very overweight. My body is very weirdly built and I carry fat around my lower back and I have a small butt. I'm a guy, mind you. And so I had trouble pulling my pants up all the way. So one time I sat down at the cafeteria with my friends and this prick behind me takes a picture of my A-crack and shows the whole table, who proceeds to laugh and point at me. I can still feel the embarrassment to this day. Spam email. We ignore it. It's just there. But it shouldn't be. I'm surprised robber calls and higher in this list. I'd tack onto this one, paper mail that you never asked for. It's a waste of resources. And getting magazines, catalogs, advertisements and other solicitations in the mail, and I've never once responded in any fortuitous way to any of them. Who actually indulges in that to inspire that potential return on investment? Really, it should be illegal to mail people trash. Being proud of and bragging about a lack of sleep as if it's some sort of virtue. Or working yourself till you are burned out. Like if you are not giving it 100% all the time you are lazy. And when you finally crash and burn due to lack of sleep and exhaustion from working constantly, you are not hard enough. Plastic, everything packaged in more plastic. I work in retail and the amount of plastic and rubbish we get from the stock is horrendous. It's so depressing to see all the time. Yup, the plastic you see on the shelves is just the tip of the iceberg in terms of waste it produces. I remember when everything was boxed or paper bagged, then we stopped that to save the trees. So instead we're killing our oceans, GG. Although back then recycled paper wasn't much of a thing. Perfect attendance being celebrated for kids. When my kid is sick, he stays home. He's healthy too. I can't imagine having a kid with a disorder that makes them prone to being sick more often and then not getting some shtye little award for not being in school every day. Kids get sick. It's not wise to send them to school anyway so they can spread their germs. Schools push attendance, because butts in seats is one of the factors that the government uses when deciding how much funding schools get. How Western nations ship their garbage to small Southeast Asian islands and call it recycling. Like 98% of Americans don't know this. Single-use plastic. It is the stupidest thing humans can do. You need spaghetti so you buy them wrapped in plastic. A material that, if not burned, will disintegrate into ever smaller particles that will creep their way back into the bodies of all living things on Earth. Is that really worth it for a little bit of convenience? Short-term diet culture. Gonna consume nothing but lemonade for a week straight. I definitely know what I'm doing. Gotta get rid of those toxins and rejuvenate yourselves. Girl, my mother has a subscription to Woman's World, and they have a new diet on the cover every week. I lost 50 pounds drinking a liter of apple cider vinegar every day, or something to that effect. It's easy to yo-yo that way. Change your diet. Don't go on a diet. Social media addiction. I can quit anytime I want. Closes Reddit. Stares blankly at home screen before mindlessly opening Reddit again. I quit Facebook by deleting the app and bookmark. At least that makes a bit of a chore to log in and check it. I struggle with this because I've mostly cut out Facebook. Only check Instagram once or twice a day, but Reddit is my big one. I hate staring at my phone for hours, but when I am on Reddit, I feel like I'm not mindlessly scrolling but rather reading interesting articles and conversations. So it's hard to get myself to stop because I feel like I am gaining something from it, but there are other things I'd much rather be doing. I used to feel like this too, until I realized that I was just filling my head with useless niche knowledge and training my brain to see everything as a debate. I log on far less frequently now. I think Reddit should be something you do for 2 hours a week and then stop, preferably on a PC. Seize this while reading Reddit. F. Bosses threatening your job or hours if you call in sick or use vacation time at inconvenient times. Agree. Going to work sick was also one of the accepted wrong things. Hope mindset changed now. I had a job 5 years ago where the boss was an a-hole. We were on a deadline on a project, but I was so sick I was hacking up stuff and generally gross. He told me to come in anyway, and when I got there he gave me cold medicine. Like I didn't have medicine at home. Obviously I wasn't very productive and everyone had to stay away from me. It was ridiculous. I've been told before, yes, technically if you're sick you can take the day, but we really want people who are gonna put in that extra effort, and sometimes we just expect you to suck it up and do what you gotta do even if you're not feeling good. I took the day off sick anyways, my first ever sick day in a little over a year, and was cut 2 days on my schedule the next week. When I asked about it I was told that I wasn't reliable lately and needed to prove myself again to get my hours back. A job making you seasonal part-time but works you at least 40 hours every week, never giving you full-time wage or insurance. 39.5 hours every week. I worked at a big box store that would send us home early if we were close to going over the old 39.5. They would also have us take a day off in order to kill overtime if we had stayed late during the week. The hourly contract that was advertised as part-time, but you work 40-hour weeks without the benefits of a permanent full-time employee, no holiday sick pay, etc. This has changed a lot since COVID, I'm assuming, but people going to work when they are sick. Not sure what it's like in the rest of the world, but I feel like in the US we've been conditioned to feel like it's worse to be an inconvenience by not showing up to work than going to work sick, miserable and getting everyone else sick. Yeah, I remember working in food service and trying to call out sick and the managers arguing with you to come anyway if you couldn't find someone to cover the shift. Theoretically you could expose not only co-workers, but tons of customers. Great company policy there. I don't know about everywhere in America, but it certainly hasn't changed anything at my place of employment. If anything, it's made it worse, because now they just say, well, it's not covered so I'm fine. My boss bragged yesterday about working through COVID and working the day her dad died. I was trying to tell her I don't think those are positive things. She's unhappy that I'm taking half a day to get my shot. Meanwhile they give us 15 vacation days but look down on us for using them. It's May and I've been out sick one day all year. No vacation. I hate my job. Having no regard for your mental health, peace of mind in the name of hustling. Funnily enough, having no work-life balance is flaunted. I've never taken a sick day. Yes, Kathy, I know. From the time you gave me the flu. Yep, not taking sick days when you're sick is just wrong. Our QA manager infected our whole office, 12 people, because he had pneumonia, or COVID. It was before the whole storm became widely known, and couldn't take time off because he was needed. Poor dude was going to the hospital after work to get IVs just to be able to go back to work. I was the only one who didn't catch it. Somehow, the colleague next to me was off work for 3 weeks and another ended up in a hospital. I have a decent job, not high paying but covers the bills with some extra and has good benefits. I work my 8 a day, 40 a week and go home. One of my friends is always pushing me to side hustle by doing Uber or getting a second job, etc. Talking about how much more I could be making. Sure, but I value my mental health and relaxation time with my wife far above an extra couple hundred bucks a month. People seem to think if you're not squeezing every bit of potential profit out of your life, you're wasting it, when in reality they are living just to work. Talking on speakerphone while in a public place. Seriously, F you. Or who play their Bluetooth speakers on trails and other natural places, literally the last place people can go to get away from modern noise. OMG, in the city I've seen people walking around with their Bluetooth speakers blasting music. They'll do it on the street, on trains, and even on the bus. Like WTF, just wear headphones. We all don't want to hear your music. Taking pictures of random people and turning them into memes. This, I hate them. There seems to be a lot of pictures circulating on Facebook of people who are very obese, very underweight or not stereotypically attractive, with things like "your third has to go on a date with this person." The comments are usually really cruel. That is a photo of an actual person. Can you imagine if hundreds of thousands of people were mocking you on a photo? Disgusting. On the plus side, when I see these it helps me easily identify dickheads I no longer want to associate with. Your boss expecting that they can contact you at any hour. I had a pretty good boss who rarely contacted me outside of work hours unless it was important. I work 12 to 8 PM and stay up late. At 1 AM, I get a phone call. "Hey, everything okay? I'm really sorry to call. I stayed late to organize the storage closet, and I just locked myself out. I figured you'd be the only person with keys that might be awake. I'll be there in 10 minutes. I'm clocking you in for an hour for this." Yup, your manager is awesome, and fair play you for helping out. This just reminded me. When I was younger I worked in a retail store for minimum wage despite running the place 3 days a week and being the second key holder. But I was a poor student and needed any job I could get. One day I left the other key holder to lock up for the day and I left early. I walked 4.5 miles in the rain and just arrived at the top of my street when I got a call. The store alarm was going off and they couldn't figure out how to switch it off, and could I please go back to stop it? Turned around and walked 4.5 miles back, still in the rain. I got to the store and the shutters were down. Called the guy and got we managed to fix it. "We forgot to call back, sorry." Queue another 4.5 miles in the rain. I quit as soon as I could find something else. No thanks. No pay. Nothing. Most of my co-workers just turn off their phone when they go home now. Or leave it behind. One made an auto-answer text message saying, "I work from 8 to 16. I straight up blocked my boss one time and said I only answer the phone for people who would come to my funeral. I started adding the phone calls to my timesheet as OT. Never got a call again. Damn, thanks for these awards." Exactly. I don't even feel bad about it. Nor should anyone else. And I only bill in full hour blocks outside of MF8-5. If you don't draw boundaries then they have zero inclination to observe any. Worked 9 days straight last week. Yesterday was my day off. Boss called me 3-4 times starting around 9 in the morning. Yeah, needless to say that messed up my entire day off. Really wish my wife would get this. Her work is effing horrible with this and they text all the time about all kinds of meaningless bullsh. Just stresses her out when she's out of work. Just effing ignore em. You ain't at work. F. That. Noise. My boss will call me at 10 PM at night, but if I call him midday while I'm at work he'll say he can't talk to me right now. Using your children to become an influencer. I have an Instagram page where I share play ideas as an educator, but my kids' faces are never in the photos. I don't mention their names either. so many parents with similar accounts are posting daily numerous photos and videos of their kids to thousands of followers and getting them involved in live feeds and stories. We have got a generation of kids who in 10-15 years time will have their entire childhood documented online, and it will all have been done without their consent. In my country we have this very famous couple of influencers who literally film their child all day long. Everything is documented and posted on Instagram. Now they just had a second baby and their child, who's 2 maybe, is madly jealous. Yet they keep filming him and posting videos where this child is throwing tantrums and crying because he hates his sister. I'm so disgusted by it. Just leave your child alone. Let him have a normal childhood without being constantly at the center of strangers' attention. I'm so worried about both those children. For your information, I don't follow them. I don't care about them. I even blocked them so I wouldn't have to see them. But they're super famous here, so I know everything because everyone keeps talking about them. Arguments being verbal battles meant to be won, not they effing aren't. Arguments are discussions with the objective of reaching a truth or consensus. It's not about dunking on your interlocutor or asserting your beliefs over theirs. Also, if I stutter or can't speak my thoughts clearly, that doesn't mean you're right or you've won the argument. I just can't speak properly in that moment for WTV reason. This is an underrated point. I absolutely hate that people bulldoze other people when the other person just can't articulate, or not native tongue, or in my case work with mostly maths PPL who aren't good with language words. Fine, calm down. Winning by default doesn't mean much. This is false. Dumb A. Haha, just kidding. I'm sorry. I agree with you. Healthy debate and good-natured banter are becoming a lost art. Having to accept cookies for every website. It's made purposefully difficult by companies, so you will just accept it. There should be an implicit deny on the browser level that just always blocks cookies outright. Well, I mean, you can disable cookies outright, but that will break virtually any stateful website. Block third-party cookies on your Chrome settings. The first-party ones 99% of the time are there for key features of a site, not ads. I think there should be a new law that on every website that wants to give you cookies, they should have a 3, maybe 5 lines of info with what they'll do with your info and not 5,000 pages that no one will read. Cost of higher education. And not just the initial costs. The scam on books is despicable. Maybe this is just a me thing, but as someone who is adopted, I am really bothered by adoptive parents who lie to their kids. I think starting your relationship with your child based on a lie is completely wrong, and it will come back to bite you later. Unfortunately, some parents who cannot biologically have children will choose to supplement this by adopting a kid and telling that kid they gave birth to them. This needlessly stigmatizes adoption by making it a shameful secret while also making sure that if this child finds out later in life, they will resent their parents 100% and never trust them again. It's just awful. My parents were completely transparent with me from a really young age and I grew up well. I love my parents and personally have no desire to ever meet my biological mother. Every adopted kid is different, but they all deserve to be told the truth. Photoshopping and social media. Sure, let me Photoshop myself into a completely different looking person and receive all praise as if it actually validates me. I'm a designer and I Photoshop images for work sometimes. Once people learned that, I'm pretty good at it. So many people ask me to Photoshop their photos for the most mundane reasons. You look great the way you are. Life is not ideal. It kills me so much on the inside when my friends ask me to Photoshop their photos to make them look less flawed, and now I absolutely refuse to do it. Well, I'm not sure if it's actually wrong, but needing a few years of experience for an entry-level job just sounds pretty wrong to me. Yeah, companies seem to not differentiate between entry, let's say at most an internship beforehand, and low-level positions. 1-5 years experience. Thanks to COVID, I graduated with no internship. Guess I'll be living in my parents' basement for eternity. Honestly, that's just clueless HR workers trying to filter out the noise. No one actually expects entry-level positions to have years of experience. They just do this to reduce their workload by reducing applicants. 30 years ago, job applications was much more straightforward, but also a lot harder. To apply for a job in most places, you would have to scour the local paper job center recruitment agency for job ads, then either phone them to get more details or post a CV and covering letter to the organization. As such, most people only applied to roles they were serious about trying for, and most job adverts would only elicit a few responses. Nowadays, however, the fact that everything is online means that the barriers to apply for a job are much lower. Anyone can have a stock CV and covering letter ready for any position and just send it en masse to the HR team. Accordingly, HR has spent this time coming up with more and more convoluted ways to make it harder to apply to reduce the candidates they have to look at. As such, they will add lines like minimum 2 years experience of entry-level job, in order to reduce applicant numbers back down to lower level, either by discouraging otherwise suitable candidates who ignore the role for not meeting the criteria, or by ignoring those applicants when they get too many. This seems to confirm my suspicion that websites that ask you for a CV cover letter but then proceed to ask for almost every piece of info on those documents typed out into separate text boxes are clunky by design. Crimes as long as you have money, and I don't mean that you can pay lawyers or something. Sometimes it just looks that you are just allowed to be a criminal if you just have money. Believing lies because it supports your worldview. And what's equally wrong is that people who believe lies is a profitable market for shtai media programs and personalities willing to continue and spread said lies. Employers expecting employees to check emails while outside of work. Years ago, I had no idea email senders could get notifications if the recipient had received and read the email. I would just check work emails and pretend I never read them until I got back into the office the next day. Then my manager baited me into lying about not reading them. Never checked work emails for real after that. How? What email service? My boss would group text me and the two others in our field all the time after 5. Sometimes as late as 9 PM. I never ever replied, and when asked why, just explained that I'm off the clock at 5, and I'm not being paid anymore. Therefore, I will get to you at 8 AM the next morning when I clock in. I was labeled as a lazy millennial, but F it. I have a life. You can't fire me for not answering a text off the clock. F that. No business would give away a key resource for nothing, and one of your key resources is time. If you have already negotiated your time, i.e. hours of work, then done deal. Good on you. I like to have a beer when I get home. I don't feel fit for work, and it would be unprofessional to do work in that state. My manager was the same thing. He would ask me to work weekends on a Friday afternoon. I told him a million times before that he can't pull that stuff, cause I have already made plans. And then he would say that I am no a team player. And one time I told him that it's not my fault you couldn't plan accordingly. But if he asks me of Wednesday to work on a weekend, I can make that happen. But he always forget. Funny thing is that he forgets to be a team player over the raises are being discussed. You can't fire me for not answering a text off the clock. Wow, that hit me hardcore just now. Something I needed to be reminded of. Thank you. Using your real name on the internet. Pigeon. Pigeon? Pigeon. Multi-level marketing company groups that target women who peaked in high school or college and lure them to think it'll make them boss babes by harassing their personal connections, contacts about leggings, candles, skin, canals, supplements. Oddly specific, yet astoundingly accurate. If I get one more hey girl scripted message on Facebook Messenger from some girl who voted me out of a study group or made me do all the work in a class project or took all my pogs away in 5th grade, I'll go crazy. The sexualization of our youth on social media and the logarithms that reward them and promote it. For young girls, it's even just finding clothing that doesn't make them look older than they are. Have an 11-year-old girl who's tall for her age. But it's very hard to find kid clothes. It's like the clothing industry has conspired that it's time for her to dress sexy. Shorts and shirts are made very short. And in the kids section recently, the new thing is athletic pants but with a matching crop top. In sizes as small as XS, meant for like 6-year-olds. You can find some things. But it's absurd how hard you need to look to make them feel like a kid. When I was in middle school, it felt like every piece of clothing in stores was either geared towards people who were much older or much younger. Like you're either wearing jeans with sparkly pink pockets or shorts that show your butt. As a result of this, my 12-year-old chooses to shop in the boys section because she doesn't like showing that much skin. She told me she wishes that it was easier to be comfortable and pretty. Banks charging you fees to use your own money. This is just one among many other practices that are wrong.